Hi, Rich Merritt here with Digital Combustion, and today's tutorial is going to be making our first simulation in Fire Studio, and we're going to try and do that in around 5 minutes or less. So let's get started. When you open up Fire Studio, this is what you're going to see as far as your interface. One of the main buttons you're going to want to know about is this library button, because right now we're in the slide panel is showing, and that shows you right now how many slides we have and how, you know, what is in the simulation, or if we want to open a new one. What we want to do right now is add our background to our simulation, because we can't build anything until we have a background on there. So let's go ahead and go into our library. I'm going to click on the default background folder at the top here, and I'm going to choose this two-story JPEG here. And once you click on the list, you can see we can select and see what background we're looking for. And then I'm just going to click the add button, and now it's on the screen. So now what we've got to do is start putting some smoke and fire here. So let's go to smoke first. And we've got some new choices in Fire Studio 7 that we'll go ahead and take one of those. Let's take this dark turbulent smoke, and I'm going to click add and put it on the screen. So once it's on the screen, we can move it around. You can see it's selected because it has the green box around it, so we know what's selected, and that'll become important once you start putting more layers on the screen. But we're just going to put it up into this window here. And you go, well, that looks okay, but I don't like to have my smoke where it doesn't go off the screen, especially a heavier column like this. So what we do is we need to edit that smoke. So we've got this smoke here selected, and then we're going to click the edit button. And that gives you all the different things that we can do. So you can see it pauses the animation, so that gives you a little better look at it, and so we can start doing things. So the first thing I want to do is I want to scale this up. And so when I scale it, I can move it. So I'm going to make it a little bit bigger so it fills that window up. We can incrementally move the layer around using these sliders, but most of the time it's just as easy to move it with your mouse and put it into place. And so we're just going to go ahead and say finish editing, and there it is. So now I've got my smoke coming out of this window. So let's go ahead and add some fire to this. So I'm going to go down to my fire library, and you can see we've got a bunch of different fires on here. And if you want to see them on a different background, this BG button means backgrounds. I like to look at it with a black background. So I'm going to go ahead and take one of these window layers, and I'm going to go ahead and add it to the screen. Here we go. So now, what are we going to do with this? This looks, it's great looking fire, but it doesn't really fit that window, but we're going to fix that. Like we did with the smoke, I'm going to go ahead and edit this, and I can change the scale of it and the rotation and all that. So I'm going to do this first, and you'll see where I'm going in a second. So I've got it. I'm going to line up that hard edge right along the hard edge of that window. And for now, I think I'm going to say that's good. But you see I've got all this other fire showing that I don't want showing. And then I also want this fire to be behind that smoke. So if you can see our layer list up here, here's our window layers at the top. We've got our background, we've got the smoke, and now we've got the fire. So the layer at the bottom of the list is the one that's closest to the front. So if I want to move this behind the smoke, I need to move it up in the list. So I'm going to go ahead and move it up, and now it's behind that smoke. Bear with me for a second, because you know that still doesn't look great, but what we're going to do is we're going to get rid of all this excess fire on the bottom. I'm going to go ahead and add a mask. And what a mask does is it allows you to hide things behind something else. So here you can see once I have this mask, anything that's behind that mask is going to be covered up. So I want to go ahead and put that mask, and you can adjust it with these dots here. On Windows, there might not be the dots, but you can still just grab the corners and move them in. I happen to be working on a Mac on this one, and the Windows is a little bit different. So once I do that, now you can see it's starting to look a little bit better. So I've got my smoke and I've got my fire. And another trick I can do is I can still edit this fire. Right now it looks a little bit too light for me. I kind of want it to have a little bit more volume to it. So I can go ahead and edit it, and I can go into the colors, and I can change the color and darken it down and make it darker, which I can do that a little bit here just to get it a little bit darker. And that's by mixing the red, green, blue channels. So I'm going to finish editing on that. But another thing I can do is I can go over into my all layer list and I can choose that smoke over here, this dark turbulent smoke, and click it, the add button. And now it's created an exact copy of that on top of this one. So I can kind of move this around. I can move it maybe to the back. And that just gives me a little bit more volume in that window. And I've got my mask still masking everything off. And so I think that's okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and hit the P on the keyboard, or this button over here for present. And that hides the interface. And it looks like I've got a pretty good looking fire here. So for this tutorial, we're just going to end with that. That's just how to make your first simulation. So to get back to author mode, I click the A button. And now I want to save this simulation because I've done all this work, and so I want to save it now. So I'm going to go to the slide panel here. So I click slide, and this is where we can open or we can also save our simulation. So I'm going to go ahead and save this. And I'm going to put a name. I'm just going to call it New Sim. I don't recommend you calling it that, but we usually put things by the address, and so that way you won't be tempted to name something that has already been named that same name on another sim. So we click select, and so you can see it's called New Sim, and now that simulation name is shown in this box here. So that's pretty much it. Now if we wanted to create a new simulation, we just hit the new button, and then that gets rid of the old one. But let's go ahead and just open that sim that we just saved, and it defaults back to the where I saved that. I'm going to click New Sim, select, and now you can see that everything's still there. Now you have a library of sims that you're starting to save, and those can be used 6 months from now, a year from now, 2 years from now, and so you have all those, and you'll have a catalog of simulations that you'll end up building. Hopefully that helps you get started on making your first simulation, and we can build off of that. Ultimately, you'll be saving and then also exporting or publishing your sims, and those will be in other videos, but for now, we've just created and saved our first sim. I'm Rich Merritt with Digital Combustion, and we will see you on the next tutorial.